here we are inside of our game development software, and now what we have to do is we have to come up with an idea, but I've already done that, so then I'm gonna get ChatGPT to do it for me. Okay, let's ask it to make us a leader stat script. Okay, here we go. I think I got one. I think I figured out what to ask. Can you make a leader stat system? So I finally got a script after like 5 minutes of sitting here. Open this up, create a new script, and I'm gonna do a little addition to actually make this leader stat script work. And there we go. This is our little addition that we have to add. So let's paste this in. Now all of this down here we can actually remove. And there we go. That's just really all we have to do. Close out that script and press play. And there we go. We have our coins. A little weird thing that this does is that you'll gather information on what you did last. A quick fix to that is just press this and create a new chat. That should refresh all the memory that's gone. Okay, here we go. We got a thing that just while we wait, it will give us coins. I'm just gonna go and take that code. It tells us to put this inside of a local script. Although we can't actually add stuff to a leader stat inside a local script. Not that I believe. Now let's test this out. Maybe I'm wrong. Looks like it proved me wrong. We have a game where we can get coins. This is wonderful. My next thing I want to do is I want to make a location that you can only get if you have enough coins to enter it. Although an AI can't really build a map for you, so the next best thing is this, the toolbox. I'm just going to insert this simple floating island model and paste this around the map somewhere. Now we don't want the base plate or else it'll kind of ruin the aesthetic of floating islands, so there we go. Am I stupid or is this not really small? This says small island. I don't think that this is small. Okay, I just got another thing just called lobby island. That looks fine. Honestly, I really like the way this looks. I'm back in ChatGPT, and this time we have to get a script that allows a player to teleport somewhere. So, let's ask it. Okay, I got one. And all I had to ask it was just to not with local player. Okay, let's copy this script. And what I've noticed with ChatGPT is that you have to be really specific with what you're asking for. You can't just be very basic or else it'll just give you a bunch of red stuff. What I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a part. Let's set the color to be something like this nice red. Let's go ahead and insert a script. And now I'm just going to go fix this up such that it works. Okay, now we have to insert a part over here. And let's rename this to something like teleport location. After doing a few edits, this works. Nice. I'll show you what I did. So all that I did was I just renamed that last little bit, character.primaryPart.cframe, because move to would actually have the character walk there. It wouldn't really be teleport. Since we got the player teleport, now we just have to copy and paste this all the way to around all the islands. Here we go. I set up all the teleportation pads, and yep, we get teleported to all the different ones. To make this a complete game, what I want to do is I want to add in a few cosmetics on each island, like a gun or something. And I'm not going to use ChatGPT, but I'm going to use the toolbox. Here's a simple gun giver name titled something that I don't understand. Okay, here we go. Now it's time to test out our gun. Okay, let's see if we can build up. We died. Do I still get to? One little detail that I want to do is I want to be able to make sure that you're able to get back. And I'm going to switch this color to be something like this yellow. And this should teleport you all the way back. I'll just make this teleport you back to start spawning. Instead of having this set to coins, let's do this time. Just like in every single crappy game, you always have your time. Name this to time. And just like this, our game is done. As you can see, we have our time. And yeah, that's really it. There we go, now we have this Battle Royale game that I'm actually going to publish to Roblox, and you can play it. Link will be in the description. Oh no! Do you agree that your game is controller compatible and contains none of the following blood or gore, intense violence, strong language, swearing, Robux scandal, drug or user reference? I don't know. I think mine includes all of that. And let's create this game. You can find it in my group, so link will be in the description. What? Error? And just like this, in about an hour and 5 minutes, 7 minutes, I've built this game. Here we are in this absolutely magnificent game. And the first thing I want to do is I'm going to go to that platform. And I went to this platform so that I can get this rainbow ball path selector. Now I can place balls around the place. I also want a sword. This game's just so good. It's on another level. I kind of want to see how chaotic this game actually gets. Now, if you enjoyed this video, why don't you go watch my other video on me building a game in 1 hour.